Okay, so here are the sand dunes. Let's tumble into one of these things and see. Oh, there's a fight. You know, I probably should have switched out my characters here. I guess it's probably not the best thing to just use these characters all the freaking time. Although when I do think Final Fantasy IX, these are the characters that I tend to envision, you know? Because they are the, like, I mean, they're the first four that you have. There are a lot more, and the other ones do get to be useful and all that, but these are the ones I always think of. I probably should have cured a little bit better than that. It's a desert monster, so I'm going to assume that I can throw ice at it and it'll work. Oh, everybody's blinded. Except for Steiner, he doesn't look blinded. Nope, it's dead. Steiner's sword looks broken. Yeah, I know it's the old-fashioned way of doing it, but I kind of like the idea that status ailments don't carry over from one battle to the next. Because, you know, it's kind of a pain in the ass to go and do this. But it's the old-school way of doing it, so, you know. Alright, that one didn't work. Let's try this again. Nope, not that one. Fell into a trap, these idiots. Oh, that's unfortunate. Just like the black mages were manipulated into helping him, he's manipulating us into helping him as well. Okay, sending us out on a quest here. It says there's an anti-magic barrier. I can't remember if that means none of my magic casting characters like VV, Dagger, or Eco are going to be able to participate. So I'm going to assume that they can't go and just take non-magic characters. Going without any argument. Well, it's easy to sit there and judge the Black Mages for what they've done and going and rejoining Kuja, the person who quite clearly has an ulterior motive for using them. But then again, like, our main characters you expect to sympathize much greater with. I don't know, I guess your opinion of this is going to be a little different because you see situation that they're in that, like, oh, you know what? We're doing this only because everybody's being held prisoner. In fact, what is it? Three or four more of our party members are being held prisoner. We're probably going to kill them if we don't do what he says. So it's easy to see why we're doing what we're doing, rather than just being so easy to judge. It's the airship, the first airship that Sid built that operated based off of steam as opposed to mist power. Sid's wife stole it, of course, and I guess now she's in the hands of Kuja. Of course, he would need to get us to go and do this, because, I mean, obviously he's dependent on magic, and so are his black mages, so he needs to send somebody else to go and get into this anti-magic joint. Of course, they can actually talk, they're just not doing it.
Thank you.
Ooh, it's been forgotten. Oh, awesome. This is exactly what I was going to need. Though I'd maybe hope to get some sort of a weapon shop for the sake of my characters who haven't had benefit of being able to upgrade their shit for a while. Alright, gotta go south. We're already facing that direction, so let this go. Game's stuttering a little bit. Oh, there's a fight. The whole new class of enemies we're gonna be facing down here. What the hell are those things? Oh, they're half fish, half animal, part human or some shit. I don't know. Oh, they're floating for some freaking reason. Why would you do that? Okay, they cast Float on some of my characters, and then the other one cast Earthquake. Why? You think they both just cast Earthquake to be doing a lot more damage. Float's a beneficial spell. Okay, now cast Float on... I don't understand why. Maybe there's some deeper meaning to this that I just don't remember. Maybe I should try to kill the one that's casting Earthquake rather than the one that's casting Float. Heavy! That's probably going to drop into the floor. Yeah, there we go. Okay, everybody just beat the piss out of this thing. Oh, nope, everyone's gonna get hit. No one went down, so. Examine potions, too. Situations like that without taking a healer along is exactly why I brought a whole bunch of regular potions. So I can, in between fights, just go and... where the hell they are. Just go and... screw up my characters. And move on. Alright. You think maybe they could have dropped us a tad closer to our destination? No, you don't think that. Neither do I. I guess I gotta do something to give you a... what? It's a walking house with an anchor. Or a fish hook. Whatever the hell that's supposed to be. If you don't know what to do, just beat the hell out of it. Oh, okay. Should have brought Quina. Probably a spell you could pick up if you could eat the thing. He's got a pretty decent offense on it. Gotta stop relying on Freya to do direct damage. Being in the back row, she doesn't really... quite sure which direction to go. It's possible that all roads lead to my destination, but, you know, not so sure this isn't the way to go. Oh, you know what? If I had the thing, I could summon a chocobo. Got chocobo tracks over there. I'm not going to do that. It's a different enemy. Cactars. Beat the hell out of these things quick before they flee. Probably shouldn't be trying to take on a cactar. This thousand needle ability. I should just run. These things look ridiculous, but they are dangerous. Ah, shit. Oh, one died. Frey is back. Okay, I almost have it. Just finished the fight. It wasted a turn hiding. God damn it. Okay, I almost have it. Well, down goes Steiner. Dead. We win. Barely, but we win. Another reoccurring enemy in the Final Fantasy series, the Cactar. I wasn't paying attention to the map. This doesn't look like the way through. I gotta go south, which is that way. Can I get through south by taking... Oh, yep, there is a path through here. Ooh, look at that. There's a new enemy again. Oh, power phone. Quake spell, it looks like. Oh, oh, took Frey out in one hit. It's like a sea turtle this time. Enemy there. There we go. And I'm going in there in the next episode. So thanks for watching.